We'd like to do a number for you that Arthur Smith and myself wrote back in 1955, and it kind of caught on and made a big splash in the 70s. It's called Dueling Banjos. Are you boys ready?
We're ready, Tom.
Okay, I thought I'd show you this version of Dueling Banjos that Don played. And I won't go into the history of Dueling Banjos too much. I think most everybody already knows the history of this tune. It was actually written by Don Reno and Arthur Smith in the early 50s, and it was originally called Feuding Banjos. And it was later picked up and put in a movie called Deliverance in the early 70s and was renamed Dueling Banjos. But we'll get into this tune here. I really love the way Don plays this because he gets right into it. He just plays it all the way through. There's no back and forth between the guitar. It's not long and drawn out. It's just a good, straightforward bluegrass tune. And I really like the brush stuff that he puts in here, and the single string stuff is really tough to do up to speed that he does. So I thought I'd show it to you, so let's get going here. We're going to start out on the fourth string, and we're just going to hit that open. It's kind of like a normal start to a bluegrass tune. All right. So we're just hitting the fourth string open, second fret, fourth fret, and then your G string open. All right. So then we're going to play this melody line that you've probably heard a million times. Okay. What I'm doing is I'm coming over here, starting out like we did. Second fret on the third string. Second string open, first fret on the second string, your first string open, back to your second fret on your second string, and then your second string open. So those are the melody notes. Okay. Now what Don does here is he's doing that little kickoff. What's happening is when I get to the first string, that first string note, your D string open, he's pinching the fifth and the first strings together. And then back to the second fret on the, or the first fret on the second string, sorry, first fret on the second string. And then your second string open. So, okay, that's all there is to it. Now, when I pinch the first and fifth strings together, you don't always have to pinch that. You can just hit the first string open. okay? Or you can pinch it. Okay? And sometimes I'll pinch the first and second strings together on that last note, so it sounds like this. Like that. It doesn't matter as long as you get those notes. Okay? And then what we're going to do is we're going to mimic that same thing, and we're going to be playing out of an F shape G chord. So, and we're going to brush it. We're going to brush our thumb down on the strings. You probably already know this if you've watched a lot of my other videos, the brush technique. I'm going to put my hand on the back of the bridge to mute it slightly, and we're going to brush with double stops to do those that same melody line. So it'll sound like this. Okay? So what I'm doing is I'm brushing the third and second strings open, grabbing this double stop. It's like a D7th, but it's really right out of your F shape G chord, you know, in the middle there, your third and second strings, that same position, just moving it back. If you did double banjo blues, same thing. Don uses that double stop a lot. But, so it will go, walk that up to your G position. So G strings, you'll brush the G and your B string open, your third and second strings open. Grab that double stop, move up to your G chord, your F-shaped G chord. Okay. And then we're going to flatten your finger across the fifth fret on the third and second strings. This is all third and second strings here, so. Walk up to that partial C chord. Then we're going to grab this G7th. It's your third fret across the first and second strings. Okay. So it's really all out of that G shape or the F shape G chord or your F seventh shape G chord. Okay. So just keep that in mind. Keep your fingers in that kind of position there. All right, so we're on that third fret on your first and second strings, brushing it. Like I said, keep your hand, put your hand on the bridge, mute the bridge a little bit to get that sound. Okay, so we're there on the third fret. Then we're going to grab that double stop on the fifth fret again on your third and second strings. All right. And then back to your original G position double stop. Okay, so. All right, so that whole first part would go. All right, so. And then we're going to do that again, and we're going to roll forward on the fifth, third, and first, yeah. So. Same notes, I'm just grabbing the fifth string before I hit that. So it'll sound like this after the brush. See what I'm doing? Okay, so. All right, let me play that whole first part before we move on to the C chord. So at this point, we're going to move to a C chord, and a couple of little things before we move there I'll show you. When you really get into this and you're playing it up to speed, Don likes to use slides in here, so I'm trying to just show you the basics of it right now, but for instance, if when I'm coming out of this G, I may want to slide back out of that, slide out of there. So, see what I mean? Put a lot of movement in your playing. Don did that a lot. He put a lot of slides and slurs and things in his playing and kept it exciting. You know, it keeps it exciting and moving along and little neat little things like that. So I'm going to show you the basic notes and then, you know, add those slides in there. All right. So let's move to the C. Now, when we get to the C chord, We're basically going to do the same notes. We're just going to bar across your fifth fret on the third, second, and third, or third, second, and first strings. The same thing we did here. All right. We're going to bar across the fifth fret, and we're going to do those same notes, just like we did there. We're just barring your finger across. So we're hitting the fifth fret, the seventh fret, and then the sixth fret, and then your first string open. So, well, not open, but we've got it barred. So, very simple. All right. So we're going to mimic that same thing with the brushes, just like we did in the G part. So this time around, when you go, we're going to grab these notes up here, right out of your F shape C, on your fourth and third string. So we're going to brush those, move back to the sixth fret, and do those same double stops. All right, same thing up here. Same thing that we did here. So we start here on your C chord, move back here to the 7th fret or 6th fret, however you want to put it. Your finger's on the 6th fret on the 2nd string and your 7th fret on your 3rd string. So it's just that double stop. Move back up to your G chord or your F shape C, sorry. Then you bar your finger across your 10th fret and then back to this 7th chord, which is your 8th fret across your 1st and 2nd strings. So, it's much easier if I just show it to you. Sometimes I get jumbled up here trying to explain it. It's hard to explain it and play it at the same time, but it's not really hard, really. Once you get this first part in your G chord, you're just going to do it in your C chord. So, okay. Now, definitely he slides back on the C chord. So when you go, so you want to slide back out of that C. So, right back into your G. Same thing we did the first time. And then we're going to go to your D. Exactly the same thing we did during the C. So we're going to bar your finger across the 7th fret. Same notes. Alright, it's very easy. And then we're going to do the same double stop break. Okay, in your D chord, your F-shaped D chord. So, whoop. And you definitely want to slide back on the D too, so. Just slide right out of that D, like that. All right, let me play that whole thing from the beginning, and then we'll get into the hard part. So, here we go. Okay, let's get into the hard part here. After this brush lick in your D chord at the very tail end, we're going to slide out of that, and we're going to get right into this double stop that we did earlier. Okay, so it's right out of your F-shaped G, third and second string. So we're going to brush that double stop right there in the chord on your fourth and third frets. So we're going to brush it, and then we're going to slide back one fret, and then immediately slide back into place. So it sounds like this. Like that. So, all right, that's the little lick there. All right, what I'm doing is I'm doing that little slide, and then I'm grabbing this double stop on your 5th fret on your 3rd and 2nd strings. The same one we did during the first part. Alright, so... Alright, we're just grabbing that double stop on your 5th fret, and then back to the double stop we did before. Alright. So, now we get into the single string part, and this is really tricky. Don is putting a lot of notes in here, and especially when it's up to speed, it's really hard to do fast. And I'll try to, it's going to be hard for me to slow it down, but I'll try to explain it the best I can. I may start rambling on trying to explain it, but I'll play it really slow so you can get it if you get lost, you know, if you happen to get lost while I'm explaining it. Maybe you can get it if I, you know, slow it down enough. But what he's doing, after you do this little... We're already in place here, so we're going to start right on that 4th fret on your 3rd string and walk to the 5th. So, 5th and 6th fret. Alright? Alright? And we're walking to the 3rd fret on your 2nd string. So, and then we're going to go back to your 4th fret on your 3rd string. To your 5th fret on your 3rd string. Alright, so. And what he's doing here is he's going to hit your G string open. And this is adding a little bit of a bounce in here. And it's hard to do fast because it's really rapid fire. So. Okay. To your 2nd fret, you're hitting that G string open. To your 2nd fret. Open. Then we're going to go back and forth on the 4th and 2nd frets and open. So, okay. All right. He just does that twice, and it's really tricky. I think I'm doing the same thing on the second half of that. Actually, instead of walking up on the 4th, 5th, and 6th, like I did at the beginning of that passage, I come back to the 4th fret and just hit the 4th fret and the 5th fret. So it's a little bit different. Alright, see the difference? Instead of, see, I'm leaving out the 6th fret on the 3rd string, so. Okay, let me play that whole little thing there really slow. Now, here's where things get kind of crazy in here, and it's going to be really hard for me to explain all of these notes in here. From a technical standpoint, I guess, it's not a lot of notes. There is a lot of notes, but there's not a lot of fingering notes here. It's just your 2nd fret and your 4th fret. But the way Don's doing it, he's adding this hop to it. And what it is he's putting in open notes between the closed notes, and it's giving it a hop. So when you come out of this thing, let's see... We're going to hammer on the 2nd fret on the 4th string, yeah. So. Okay, now that was very confusing for me to understand. It's so simple, it's hard to really understand the notes there. So I may stumble on, you know, trying to explain it. I just have to feel it, you know what I mean? All right, that's the first half of that last little single string lick. play that again. Hammer on the second string on the fourth string, the second fret on the fourth string, sorry. See, right after I hammer on, I'm hitting the G string open, so. And I'm hitting that G string two or three times there. I think I'm hitting it three times. Hitting the G string open again after the second fret. Okay, so. Okay. So that last little bit. Hammer on again the second fret on the fourth string. Okay, it's just another variation from that first little part. So, okay. Let me play that whole single string part again. Like I said, I probably didn't do a very good job of explaining it, but it's hard to explain it and play it at the same time. It's hard for me to call out all the number of times I'm hitting the G string open. So let me play that whole thing there. Okay. I hope you can get it from that. Let me play that last part again, because that is really tricky. It took me a long time to figure that out. So, okay. Now, if you really slow it down and listen to what Don's doing there, he's also, I don't want to complicate things here, but he's actually pulling off that second fret too sometimes. So, for example, so see what I did there? I pulled off on that second fret on the third string. So, all right, just little things like that that Don would do. That, you know, you don't really pick up on when you're listening to it the first time around, but it's something a little extra if you really sit down and try to figure it out. Don is like that. There's a lot of tunes he does that you think you have the notes correct, but when you really slow it down and listen to it, he's doing something extra in there that makes it sound good. That may be the difference between, you know, why am I not sounding like Don right there? I know I'm hitting the right notes, but you might not be hitting the right notes right. You know what I mean? So you may not be slurring that note. You may not be pulling that note like he's doing on the record or whatever. But like I said, sometimes he's pulling off on that second fret. So, okay. In the heat of the moment, Don is pulling and snapping those fingers, you know, and that really adds something to it. You know, it gives it a little human touch to it. A lot of people today play stuff, single string stuff, so perfectly, it sounds like a computer playing it. But Don's not like that. It's really organic. It's coming from him. He's pulling those little notes and slurs and things in there. So always keep that in mind when you're trying to figure out something that Don's doing. But anyway, that's it there. Let me play the whole thing up to that point, if I can. Okay, if you can make it through that single string part alive, then don't worry, you're almost done. It gets a little easier from this point on. But Don does a lot of cool little licks in this last half of the tune. A lot of the stuff he puts in Charlotte Breakdown, Lonesome Road Blues, Dear Old Dixie, just basic bluegrass breakdown type tunes that he would use these licks in. But really, when you get out of this single string part, we're going to go right into your C chord. And I guess I'll play the whole second or the whole last half of this tune so you'll have an idea of what I'm going to show you here. I'll start with the single string part, the last passage of the single string. So that's basically the last half of the tune, and like I said, we're going to go right into your C chord. So the melody notes are basically walk right into that C chord, and I'm just going to roll forward on your fifth, third, and first, and hammer on that second fret on your third string. So and hit your second string open, and then hit it again, and hammer on the first fret, which is your C note. You're going to be in C chord at that point. So. Just roll forward on your fifth, second, and first strings, and you're holding that C chord down. And Don does something interesting here. He actually slides into this G seventh on your third fret on your first and second strings. You're holding that down just like shucking the corn. All right, third fret, second, and first strings. So we're going to slide into that G seventh while we're still actually in C chord. So. See what he's doing? So, and then actually when it goes to G chord, he slides back into that G seventh again. So, still rolling forward on the first, or your fifth, second, and first. So, all right. And then we're going to slide back on your third string from the third fret to the second fret. Hit your G string open, maintaining your roll, you know, of course, you know, just rolling forward. So, okay, and then we're going to hit your fourth string on the second fret, and then your fourth string open. All right, so it'll sound. All right, at that point, we're going to D. So we're going to slide into this D chord that Don loves to do. I've shown this in a lot of other videos. Basically what he's doing is he's sliding up to this bar chord on your 7th fret, like you would bar across the 7th fret for your D. But we're going to leave your D string open, your first string open. So we're going to slide up, and we're going to hammer on that 7th fret from your 6th to your 7th. Leave that first string open. All right, so. All right. So then we're going to hold that position. It's just, you're still got the two strings in the middle mashed down, your third and second strings. We're going to slide that up to the 12th fret. Leave your first string open. Slide into that 12th fret, and then we're going to walk your third string down to the 10th fret, and we're going to grab this G 7th. Still keep your first string open. So, all right, this is the same type G 7th you would do out of your barred position. All right, but we're leaving the first string open. So. It gives it that little, that drone effect that Don's doing. All right, all forward. So, and sometimes Don double thumbs, I guess you would say. He'll hit the G string and hit it again. So, he does odd rolls sometimes like that. It's just a matter of what you want to do. You never set in a certain way of doing anything. Do what feels right to you at the time. That's the way Don played. But that's the basic, you know, thing he's doing. So, all right, back down to that G7th. And then we're going to slide into this unique chord position Don does a lot in other tunes. He did this, first time I heard him do it was in Follow the Leader, I believe. But it's a 7th chord. We're going into a C chord at this point, so we're doing a C7th, really. It's the 12th fret on your 3rd string, the 11th fret on your 2nd string, and your 10th fret on your 1st string. So it's just in a row, if you can see my fingers there. All right, so and you can do that in any chord. All right, it's a good little chord. I think I've taught that in a few other videos, but good chord. Adcock uses that a lot. You do all kinds of little neat things there, but anyway, that's a good chord to learn. I got sidetracked there on that chord, but that's a great chord to learn, so learn that one. But here we're going into your C7th version of that. Just roll forward. You can also roll on the 5th, 2nd, and 1st, because the 5th string is the same as the 12th fret on your 3rd string. So you can slide into that. You know, begin the roll on your 3rd, 2nd, and 1st, and then start rolling on your 5th, 2nd, and 1st. So however you want to do it. Just keep that going, and then you're going to slide into your F-shaped G on your 1st and 2nd strings, right out of that position. All right, this is very much like Charlotte Breakdown, the way he plays Charlotte Breakdown. So you're going to slide into that 1st and 2nd string out of your F position G. So, and I'm rolling on my 5th, 2nd, and 1st. And slide up to your D position G on your 1st and 2nd strings, right out of that position there. So, all right. And then we're going to go to your D chord, your F-shaped D. So, I'm going to hammer on to that 3rd string, or actually your 11th fret, your 10th to 11th fret on your 3rd string. Right in that F position G, or F position D, rather, sorry. So, all right. Hit that peak note there on your 1st string out of your D chord. And we're going to grab this note here on your 13th fret. Or not your 13th fret, it's 14th fret. And then we're going to do, this is kind of like a little Scruggsy thing. I'm sure you've heard Scruggs do it. Stuff like that. So you probably already know this, but Don does this particular little thing a lot. He does this in Charlotte Breakdown too, so. All right. I'm just hammering on the 2nd string. Well, hammer on the 11th fret to the 12th fret on the 2nd string. So holding down that 14th fret on your 1st string. So I'm just doing a little roll there on your 5th to the 2nd to the 1st. So end up back here on your D position G on your 1st and 2nd strings. So at the end of it, I'm going to grab this 11th fret and just kind of choke it a little bit. Just slide out of that. All right. You probably already do a lot of that stuff like that. Let's see. All right. Let me play that whole second half for you again, kind of slow. goes right back into. So it just starts it right over again. So that's pretty much the whole thing. Well, okay, we made it all the way through Dueling Banjos, so let's do that ending that Don did. And this ending has two parts to it, and the first part is basically Don's version of the old shave and a haircut ending that just about everybody does, except for he does it differently. And the second part is a single string ending that he's done in a bunch of different tunes, and it's quite a handful. There's a lot of notes, and I'll do my best to try to explain them to you, but I may get jumbled around here and confused myself because I've never broken this ending down, so we'll see what happens. The first part of it is we're going to be holding down your G chord out of your D-shaped G, that is, on your second and first strings, your 8th fret on the second string, 9th fret on the first string. So we're holding that down, and we're going to roll forward on the 5th, 2nd, and 1st. And we're going to grab this 11th fret, but hold that chord down. We're going to grab this 11th fret on your 2nd string and roll forward. Alright? And then we're going to hit your 8th fret on the 2nd string, which you should be already holding down. So, alright. And then we're going to change your hand around and we're going to grab this 9th fret on your 3rd string. And we're going to roll on your 5th, 3rd, and 1st. And we're going to leave that 1st string open. So, okay. And then we're going to slide from your 8th to your 9th on the 4th string and hit your G string open. So, like that. All right, now this has a slight pause in it if you listen closely. I'm pausing on that G note on your 8th fret on the 2nd string. Sometimes Don would keep the roll going, so it'll sound like that. So, you can choose whichever one you want to do, but I kind of like the pause. Sometimes I'll do the fast one. Usually if I'm playing a really fast tune, I'll keep the continuous roll going, but I like the pause. Or, it's tricky to get that continuous one. So, choose whichever one you want to do. Now let's do this second half of this thing. I mean, this is a tricky little single string lick. And you can transpose it to any key out of your, if you're using a D-shaped chord, you can do this ending anywhere. So we're going to be playing right out of your D-shaped G in this instance. So we're going to start on the 9th fret on your 3rd string, and we're going to walk up on the 2nd string to on the 7th to the 8th. So, all right. Okay. 9th fret, 3rd string, 7th fret, 2nd string, 8th fret, 2nd string. So, and then we're going to come back to the 9th fret on your 3rd string. And then we're going to go to your 7th fret on your 3rd string and walk up to the 9th again. So 7, 8, 9. So, and then back to your 7th fret on your 3rd string. To your 9th fret on your 4th string. I got to think about it. Right? So 9th fret on your 4th string, and then back to your 9th fret. Now I like to flatten my finger down because my finger's already there on the 4th string, so I like to flatten it down to the 3rd string. You don't have to do that, but I'll flatten mine down on the 9th fret on your 3rd string. So, okay, see what I'm doing? Back to the 7th fret on your 3rd string. So, and then to your 9th fret on your 4th string. I see. Yeah. So I told you I'd get fumbled up trying to explain it. I've never tried to break this down, so. Back to the 9th fret, then to the 8th fret on your 4th string, back to the 9th, and then your G string open. So, the whole thing. And that's a lot of notes, especially get it up to speed. It's a lot of stuff in there. So the whole thing. Okay, so that would be the whole ending. Now, there is a different variation of the single string lick that may help to get it in there on faster tunes. What we did here was. So that's kind of like continuous notes coming out. There's a lot of notes there. Sometimes Don would go. Stuff like that. You see how he's pausing? He's actually using a pause to leave out notes, but it still sounds good. Well, okay, that was it for Dueling the Banjos. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you have any questions regarding this song or any of my songs that I've posted, always feel free to contact me, and I'll do my best to answer your questions or song requests. And like I said, I'm always here for you. I'll be glad to help anytime I can.